Hi, my name is Jihoon Jung. This is first lecture of deep learning on healthcare. I want to recap last lecture shortly. At first lecture, we reviewed the role of deep learning on healthcare, and I covered different data types, different types of the healthcare and medicine, and their approach to deal with these different data also different. In second lecture, I explained the typical deep learning usages on healthcare, such as medical image diagnosis, prediction analysis, and so on. In last lecture, I picked up some myths of deep learning, such as IBM Watson can do everything, and usual problems of startups. I also explained what's different deep learning on healthcare from usual deep learning project. Okay, in this lecture, I will explain case study of a healthcare deep learning startup. I will tell the story of Lunit, one of the representative healthcare deep learning startup from South Korea. I think this is an exemplary growth story of healthcare deep learning startup. Lunit's motto is data-driven medicine, data-driven and data-driven imaging biomarker, to improve the medicine. I'm one of the first angel investors of this company and also working for this company as an advisor. Anyone who don't know well about Lunit, here are several core accomplishments of this company. Their current representative product is Lunit Insight, deep learning-based interpretation software for chest x-ray and mammography. Not only they released this software already in service for over 70 countries and analyzed 1.5 million cases, they also verified this software's validity with many research collaborators. The paper published in Radiology with several hospitals in Korea and United States was selected as top five most viewed articles in 2018 Radiology. And the paper published in JAMA Network Open was tweeted by Eric Topol, showing DLAD, it means deep learning based automatic detections. Performance of absolutely greater than board certified radiologist like this in four different major diagnoses of chest x-ray. They've also got great results in various competitions. In 2015, they've got Lunit ranked fifth in LOC task in ILS VRC 2015. They've got also top positions at Tupac 2016 and Chameleon 17. It is a pathology analysis contest. And CB Insight took Lunit as top 100 AI startups, and Nvidia appointed this company as top 5 AI startups for social impact. Great accomplishment in such a short period of time, isn't it? But their start was quite different from current situations. They started a student research group, KILDI, at KAIST. This is very difficult to pronounce, so that they changed their name to Lunit. Impressed with ImageNet challenge in result of 2012, founder of this company, Anthony Beck, created a study student research group in 2012. Since there was no professors and laboratories focused on deep learning at that time in Korea. And after 2 years preparations, they attended ILS VRC 2014, and they've got seventh rank at classification plus localization task. Great accomplishment as a student research group, isn't it? after that, they've kicked off startup with name of Kildi. They started business something like a detection desk demo, like here. One of the first seed investments done by KQ Ventures. It's a subsidiary startup investment fund by Kakao, Korean number one messenger platform. At the time, they focused on fashion industry. This is an excerpt of their interview with Korea Times. The fashion industry in particular has significant potential. For example, when a consumer snaps a photo of something they like on the street, they can upload the photo on a visual recognition app to find the same or similar products and stores that sell such products. Do you think this is a good business model? This is very tough goal for the startup. They should compete with B2C giants such as Google, Facebook, and Amazon. Even though they have a competitive spot this time, it was very clear that this kind of business is very difficult to compete with big companies. I met this team at this point. I suggested them, if you can pivot the company into healthcare deep learning company, I can help you. I will invest some money and connect with the hospital project. Healthcare data, especially medical imaging data, is very hard to access and get right to use for deep learning. So if we can accomplish great results based on good data, we can compete with big companies. And the founder, Mr. Peck, agreed. That was the very important decision to make current Lunit. We started to think what is the target and decided to focus on breast and lung cancer. The reason why we chose these two cancers is that the problem is very clear and big. Chest x-rays miss 26% of the lung cancer, and when we use low-dose CT out of every 1,000 people screened, then 15 will be diagnosed with lung cancer, but but 20 will undergo unnecessary invasive procedures such as bronchoscope and thoracotomy directly related to the screening. And 550 out of 1,000 will experience unnecessary alarm and repeated CT scanning. So that's a big false positive. Too much false positive exam and the medical cost spent. For breast cancer, screening mammograms miss 20% of breast cancers. Out of every 1,000 women screened, 5 will have breast cancer, but 100 will be recalled for further testing. It also have too much false positive and also a big miss too much. This is not the first trial to improve early diagnosis of breast cancer and lung cancer using software. There are software called CAD. It is a computer-aided diagnosis. But their performance and clinical value is not that satisfactory, so that medical society actually reject the wide adoption. Here is the graph from 2015 JAMA Internal Medicine paper by Lehman. And it shows no CAD use. It actually no difference with CAD use. PA use here is even worse with CAD. We thought deep learning can improve these situations, and we developed concept called DIB, data-driven imaging biomarker, which means deep learning image analytics can be used like biomarker for certain disease. Current diagnostic paradigm is feature or characteristics of disease defined by human, and feature extraction by human, and the interpretation by human. But we think if we can use DIB, data-driven imaging biomarker, the feature will be learned from data and extracted by machine, but it will be interpreted by human. Now we need to get actual proof of concept for this hypothesis. POC study was done at 2016 with the help from Korean Institute of Tuberculosis. They had 10,848 chest X-rays images with 7,020 normal and 3,828 tuberculosis chest X-ray images. We applied deep learning not only to classify normal with TB cases, but also displayed class activation maps as a DIB heat map for helping physicians diagnosis process. And two papers were published in SPI Medical Imaging 2016. This is somewhat interesting result. In this graph, test for Shenzhen data test for Shenzhen data was much better than Montgomery dataset. Our result was better for those two dataset previous SOTAs, but the gap was bigger at the Shenzhen dataset. We think that the characteristics of the Shenzhen dataset is much similar to our training Korean dataset. After this research, we developed the first generation DIB software for chest X-ray, and it had quite good result, but not satisfactory, and there was some situation, some limitations. Okay, but time is up for this lecture. Remaining story of this case study will be continued in next lecture. Maybe that will be the last lecture of this deep learning on healthcare lecture series. See you next lecture.